Right, so there's this little game called Fellandia. It's pretty good. It's a roleplay game where you dig up chests for money to buy accessories and den items. Most of the characters are lions, but it's extremely fantasy-based, so there's a lot of characters that are hybrids. They're dragons, fairies, magic, all that. Well, I've decided to draw my characters that I made in that game, so now you have to listen to me rant about my OCs. Starting with the most recently created one, Tamulus is a pretty decent guy. He's willing to help strangers, but while he might be kind, he isn't always upfront with the truth. That's not to say he's a liar. If you asked him about something, he would most likely tell you the truth, but you would have to ask. I haven't completely worked out why. All I know is that he had a boyfriend that left him, so... For the most part, he's just a normal guy with some baggage. He's named after the scientific name for Indian Red Scorpion. Also, I forgot to draw his horns in the during the speed paint, so don't mind the randomly appearing horns when you see it in the finished design. In-game, I made his design with the lynx ears, large eyes, scorpion tail, canine muzzle, glasses, bone earrings apparently, which I also forgot about, flower bracelet, right eye covering, hyena fur, feet stripes, muzzle stripes, large claws, fuzzy cheek tufts, scars, and devil horns. He's a member of Solaris Pride, and the venom in his stinger is pretty weak. Might cause some minor discomfort. And that's all I have to say about Tamulus. Like you're hanging by a thread, but you gotta survive, cause you gotta survive. Like your body's in the room, but you're not really there. Like you have empathy inside, but you don't really care. Like you're fresh out of love, but it's been in the air. I'm a past repair. A little bit tired of trying to care when I don't. A little bit tired of quick repairs to cold. A little bit tired of sinking. There's water in my boat. I'm barely breathing, trying to stay afloat. So I got these.
Another New Year's Eve marks the passing of time. Another year of promises weighing on my mind. I couldn't tell you where I've been. The longer nights just blur through shorter days. It feels like there will never be a chance to start again. And the paper's full with forgotten goals left there by my.
Secondly, we have Wisp. She's a doctor from the Shimmering Mountains who is really good at her job, not just because she is a talented healer, but also because she is aided by spirits. She is pretty spiritual, which is one of the reasons she has her mane grown out like that, but she's also from Lunaria, so she would probably be pretty fluffy anyways. She has sacrificed her eyes in exchange for a spirit eye that allows her to see certain things her old eyes cannot. But you know, she's still blind. As far as her personality goes, she's pretty cold with no sense of humor or any social skills. That's kind of what happens when you go far away from everybody, higher up in the mountain to perfect your craft. She actually got a redesign recently, so I'll put up a picture of what she used to look like. I definitely like her new design a lot more. The accessories I use for her are default ears, no eyes, mythical tail, default muzzle, brew belt, Lunarius necklace, eye bandages, poofy mane, hyena fur, muzzle stripes, face mask, both lower and upper fur, dragon fins, spirit eye, ram horns, and cyber teeth. Saber teeth, it's saber teeth. As mentioned before, she's from Lunarius Pride. But she also goes wherever she needs to be. Not that she'd be very happy if she had to leave the mountain. And that's Wisp. I guess I'll just let y'all watch the speed paint, and we'll pick back up at the next one.
Veins, I'll go away. I'm sorry that I ruined your day.
Evelyn,
why do we bother to stay?
Why are you running away?
Don't you feel like severing?
Everything's just come together.
It's broken, I don't want to play.
We grew up closer than
anything.
Closer than anything.
Shared our bed
and wore the same
talked
clothes.
About everything.
Spoke about so many things.
What shall we wear tonight?
What shall we eat today? Can we go ice
but
skating?
We just did that yesterday.
Should we be firemen? Can we be astronauts? What if they find
they're
us?
They're not looking anywhere.
Evelyn,
Evelyn,
why do we bother to stay?
Why are you running away?
Don't you feel like severing?
Everything's just come together.
It's broken, I don't want to play.
Fill my glass, let's drink a toast.
This is our birthday.
So why are we weeping?
At your side
I feel like a ghost.
I wake up first
and I stare at you sleeping.
What shall we wear tonight?
What shall we eat today?
Do you think I should marry
we
him?
We just met him yesterday.
Should we be movie stars?
Will we be millionaires?
I want to be famous.
They're watching us anyway.
Evelyn,
Evelyn,
why do we bother to stay?
Why are you running away?
Don't you feel like severing?
Everything's just come together. It's
broken,
past.
I don't want to.
Character I made in Fellandia, Lighthouse. Yes, they are low-key and Our Flag Means Death reference. Lighthouse has gone through multiple redesigns, and they are my favorite child. By first character, I mean they are the character I spawned in as if for the very first time. I don't typically use them for roleplay, I mostly just chest hunt as them, which I do a lot of. Lighthouse is an immortal being who wanders the dunes. There are two things that they want, gold and knowledge. They want to know everything there is to know, and they just like gold. They don't really want to be wealthy. They don't even really have a concept of wealth. They just simply like gold. They are kind of like a spirit. Some lucky souls might spot its lantern in the night. I also just thought of this now, but what if they were invisible in the light, but you could see them in the shadows? That sounds cool, especially since I imagine them having some sort of cave they hold all their stuff in. They're pretty small, about the size of a lion cub, a little bit smaller. They are very curious, sometimes coming up to travelers on the dunes that are lost or hurt. They stay away from most others, though, because it's aware that there are those that will take advantage of it. For its in-game design, I used the double ears, blind eyes. They aren't actually blind, the blind eyes just look cool. Sea dragon tail, beak, lantern, gold braces, ring cuffs, emo markings, cheetah markings, which I forgot to draw, large claws, griffin feathers, firefly aura, and face crystals. Since they also recently got a redesign, I'll put their old design up now. That's all of my characters I'm going to show, so enjoy the speed paint.
The moss grows on the north side of the trees. Legend has it when the rains come down, all the worms come up to breathe. Legend has it when the sunbeams come, all the birds they open with their leaves. Legend has it that the world spins round on an axis of 23 degrees.
Cyclical motion lay sway. And though the aeons may pass as slow as the sands of an hourglass, every blink we count it claims that even the mountains can change.
Let it come down.